House of Hits studio in Miami. The premier audio and visual studio experience in the world. Undisputed, undeniable, can't be refuted on any level. When you walk through these doors, you are walking into greatness, supreme being. DJ Khaled, Mary J. Blige, Busta Rhymes, Jack Harlow, the Migos, Kanye West, the Game. When they want to document their greatness and record their legacy in Miami, when they touch down House of Hit Studios, period. There's certain places you go. There's certain environments you want to be inside to reach your optimum level, your zenith. When people go and play the Madison Square Garden in New York City, they play at a higher level than they do in any other stadium. That's because they know the history of that building. Same thing here with the House of Hit Studio in Miami. The ecosystem they've created is on another level. Hip hop since 1987, the number one hip hop blog and media outlet in the world, undisputed, cannot be denied, cannot be refuted. Since 1987, they have been the most connected brand to the streets, documenting the authentic stories without compromising integrity. They don't do it for clout at Hip Hop's in 1987. They do it for the purity of the game, giving you the real story. The first Meek Mill freestyle ever recorded on Hip Hop's in 1987. Sitting down with Nipsey Hussle back in 2014 talking about Victory Lap before it was even released. Shout out to the great Nipsey Hussle. Hip Hop's in 1987, House of Hit Studios in Miami. Two juggernauts, two conglomerates. Now we document history. Now we record our legacy. Welcome to the Hip Hop Since 1987 podcast, coming to you live from the House of Hit Studio in Miami. Let's get it, people. You know how we do it.
People, right now, we are live from the House of Hits. Let me explain how big this moment is right here. When I wanted to launch a podcast face-to-face, I wanted to do it on a platform I felt like justified the history and the rich culture of hip-hop. I wanted to do it on a platform I felt could give justice to the real talents of artists out here that are straight out the mud, from the block, have a dream, and they need a platform that can launch them onto a national stage. When I think about House of Hits, I think about the culture that they've created from two young men born from immigrant parents and say, I got a dream. And then they go and they create something. And then from their minds, their vision, it blooms, it mushrooms to the number one visual recording studio experience in the country. Because this studio, this place, makes you feel like I've arrived. I am here. Because that's what great environments do. You think about championship team. You think about when you go and they say, we want you to play for the Lakers. We want you to play for the Knicks. We want you to play for the Celtics. We want you to play for the Patriots. You know, you playing for great organizations, and when they walk you through trying to entice you to be there, you say, man, look at those banners in that Boston Garden. Look at those 17 championships at the Forum. Well, now it's crypto.com. But you feel like Shaq, Kobe, Kareem, Worthy. That's why we're here. Today, House of Hit Studio Miami, Hip Hop's in 1987, the number one outlet for hip hop and music and news. Black owned, been connected to the streets from day one. Unfiltered, uncensored media outlet for news on hip hop and the culture and lifestyle. But most importantly, they represent artists that truly, not about the clout, but about the actual talent. And today, I'm speaking to a guy I've been knowing for over 3 years. We go back from Just Another Day to Barry Gordy to Athletic Drip to Ball Hog to you name it, records, Reflections, Paper Chasing. This guy been known for 3 years now, major recording artist, verified Instagram artist, one of the most publicized artists I ever written about, Big Ed Bands. Big Ed Bands, welcome to the House of Hits studio and the Hip Hop's 1987 podcast, my brother. Welcome.
You already know what it is. Big Head got bands.
No doubt, man. You know how to get that Diddy intro, man, as usual. We've been doing this for a minute.
Yeah, I know.
Let me just break the ice this way. Like, in all seriousness, you know, our journey is special because we've been walking this path for, I've seen your growth, I've seen your evolution as in your music. You know, when you first brought Just Another Day, and I'm like, man, who you talking about? And you was like, I'm talking about my lady. I'm talking about my wife. Like, I said, you know, this how I'm feeling. I'm like, that sound like Round the Way Girl with LL Cool J. We was talking about that. I'm like, I really like that record. That's, I'm going to write about it. And I will write about it. And we was talking about, then you moved up to Barry Gordon. And we, I said, your sound is arriving. I said, your plane getting ready to leave the tarmac. And then we moving to Athletic Drip. And then I was like, we put it over there with Mr. Cheeks. And he was like, you know, I like that, keep my jewels in the cooler. He was talking about that. He was like saying that line meant something. Because, you know, he's a hip-hop legend, historian, whatever. Indeed. And then I just saw, you know, to see somebody stay with something, invest in something, continuously try to build equity in something that hasn't fully come to fruition is what makes the process beautiful. Because you believe. Nobody can believe more than you.
Right.
Not your family, not your friend, not your girl, not whoever. Because guess what? It's your thing. I know that because I've been told that myself. You believe in you, but we don't believe in you like that. So you got to make us believe. So you got to face that pressure. For everything you've been through, ups and downs with music and life in general, how are you feeling in 2022 right now? That's more about your life, about your music. Just tell me your state of mind. Tell me about your mental health. How you feeling?
Man, I'm blessed and not stressed, man. And, you know, happy to have my family. You know, it's a lot to take in, but you have to take it one day at a time.
Right.
And it's like things you take for granted, you can't take for granted anymore.
Right.
Especially when you're younger and you get older and you be like, man, I got to move wiser. So it's like when you move, you don't move as one, you move as all.
Right, Wolfpack.
Yeah, so exactly. It's like that's how it moves.
Exactly. Let me tap into this part because being a dream chaser is stressful.
Right.
It's taxing on your team. At this point in your career, how do you balance everything? Because we're going to get into the music in a minute, but I just want people to get to know you and your psyche and how balanced you are, how humble you are, and just how much you always talk about family. You always talk about, I got to pick up my son. You always talk about, I got to be there for this. You know, talk about you from... How has pursuing this dream humbled you to appreciate your environment, your team? Take your time.
That's a hard-hitting question.
It's a real question.
It's to the point. I don't want to simplify that question again.
This journey has put, you know, it takes a lot of time, it takes effort, it takes money, it takes stress. But you still have to have a team around you, like LeBron. Mm-hmm. He plays basketball. He runs multiple businesses. He's worth $800 billion. But that's not his whole life. Somebody got to take care of this. Somebody got to take care of that. You always hear him say, my wife, it wasn't for her, I wouldn't do this.
Right.
You know, so what I'm saying is that I know you have a second life away from Big Head Bands, the artist.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying with everything you've put into this, you know, the costumes, the clothing, the music, the studio time, the hours, you know, all that is good, but also because you're more mature now, you're older, how much did it make you appreciate now how much your team has supported you up until this point? That's what I'm saying.
Well, my wife is my number one fan and my number one supporter. And without her, I couldn't do as things that I do. And we move as one, so when we run, it's like I can break away from her when she at the office. Like, I do my office thing and
yeah,
I leave.
I know.
Hit the studio. It's just like, and then I go pick up my son. So it's like I get like about three, four hours in the studio a day, and then I go family time. So it's just like I know how to level it out and make it make sense. You know what I mean? So it's like, it's real.
Got it. Let me segue into this, because you know, I'm your personal biographer. You know, I wrote every article about you.
Right.
So, your day, you know, you always say, I'm like, Bands, man, jump on the call tonight. And I forget sometimes, you be like, man, I got to be up at 3 in the morning, 4 in the morning.
Yeah.
So, in a brief, like, 65, 90 second window, you're up at what time in the morning? And then what is it like? What does that run time look like for you? I'm doing this. I'm doing this. Kind of like run us through it on that level.
We up at what? 5:30. 5:30. Shower. Brush teeth. Talk about the agenda for the day. Wake up my son. Then we take him to school. Then we head to the office. I do my accounting work. She does her billing because we run a horse farm, me, her, and her brother. So It's like, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's a cycle. So we have to stay on task. We can never fall off.
Voltron.
It's always going to be moving.
Right.
So if I fall off, she picks me up. If she falls off, I pick her up. So it's just like, you know what I mean? It's a lot. It's family. Like, mm-hmm. You can't beat it.
So from 5 a.m. to about, you know, what, 6 in the evening, you still running?
Yeah, about 5, yeah.
7,
depends on
8.
If you got sports.
Yeah, because I know you're on the football team.
Yeah,
I know, the football team. So, super dad, super husband, or try to be super husband, I always say try to be. You know what I'm saying? Because you know how that goes. You know what I'm saying? So you try to be that. I always say sometimes with men, we could be better fathers and better husbands.
Right.
Because it's easy to connect with something that came from her. Because you look at that as something that you can make a better version of you, mm-hmm. for all the things you messed up on.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's how I kind of work. It's weird, but that's how I work. Yeah. Like, I want you to be this. So you're like, no, do this, teach them all this. So I say all that to say this, because I want people to really get to know you as a person. That's the difference with this podcast versus the traditional hip hop podcast and stuff like that. Like, when you're by yourself, I want you to keep it 100. Like, what are you most thankful for, man? Like when you look at, I'm talking about when you look at where you've been. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, well, I'm talking about where you've been, and you don't have to reveal everything, but like when you step away from it all, because your family got their feelings about their lives, but you have yours. Mm-hmm. What do you say to yourself in private saying, I'm really thankful for this?
I'm really thankful that God brought me out of the darkness, because, you know, we was in the dirt. Like, I was in the dirt, like, for real. I mean, you know, preacher's kids got it the worst. You know, we jumped off the porch early, especially me. So it's just like you hit your head first before anybody else.
Right.
But you got to learn from it.
Mm-hmm.
To not hit it again.
Right.
So it's just like living is a learning experience for me. Mm-hmm. And I'm blessed to be where I'm at now, because it was rough. I mean, for real. But it took heavy prayer from my parents, because it could have went left. It could have at any second. But prayer, heavy prayer, kept me focused and just stayed course.
I want you to tell me this. I want you to break down the moment when you felt like, she can change my life. When you said to yourself, like, this person here, her, H-E-R, like the singer, can change my life. Because for men, it's different.
Right.
You know, like, we men are territorial. In the jungle, female lions hunt, the male lion, we protect the cave. It's very territorial, very egotistical, because it's ego for a female lion to go hunt and for a male lion to be here. But when did you say, she can change my life? Just like music changed your life, right? You always tell me music. Your dad's legendary, what he did with James Brown and the band and the Motown, all that stuff. That had an impact on you. You know, your pop is real to you. He's real. We've spoke about it in private. How did she change your life? Briefly, just, you don't have to give me all the, you know, just tell me.
You about to make me tear up. Nah, I'm just playing. But, man.
Just give me a one-liner. Give me an LL Cool J line. I need love line, something. When was that moment you said, she can change my life? Because that's what had to happen for you to be here. I mean, I guess.
When she told me, are you ready for this?
Wow. So she made her chest move. She was 3 moves ahead of you. Wow. Tell me what your gut was saying from a street dude perspective, from a hustler perspective. You got a gun to your head. What'd you say?
Like, yeah, like, let's roll.
Yeah. But at that moment, that encapsulated how much you care and love her.
Right.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, yeah, definitely. So at that moment, that kept that there from that. And that's why I said it, because the reason why I'm going down this path with you is because it's an autobiographical experience in life.
Mm-hmm.
It's never just about a song. It's never about a beat. It's not about the chain. It's not about the bucket hat. It's not about the cars.
Right.
Because you're a person. You know, you always hear celebrities or people that make it say, you know, this is who I am. You'll see Khaled, this one might put his son on the cover. Like, he ain't even a rapper. But he got his son on the cover because to him, that's what he living for. Mm-hmm. So I'm saying that because sometimes the narrative isn't properly told about artists independent. Because you're independent. You don't have Goldman Sachs backing you. You don't have Merrill Lynch with the bull behind you. Your team is your hedge fund. They're your support. They're your psychological ecosystem. They're your bridge when you don't know where to go. And they're your shoulder to cry on when you fail. That's why I think it's important for people to know how much of a family man you are, but how much it means to you to be there for your son, to pick him up. You send me pictures of him playing football and they won this many games and you'll be telling me, yo, I'm at the game, and you'll be showing me like you and your spouse, y'all doing this or at the derby or whatever, you know what I'm saying, doing things. The unity, that's why it's important. So I want to lay that down. Let me morph into this. We got Big A Bands right now on the Hip Hop's 1987 Censor Podcast. We doing it big, so all that stuff is great. So listen, let me tap in this part here. You looked in the mirror one day and said, I want to be a rapper. I want to go down this path. I have a talent. I have a belief in myself enough to say, I'm going to start a company, Got Bands Entertainment, LLC, and I'm going to start putting my record label into motion. What drove you to that point? What was the bridge you had to cross to get there?
Really, my dad being screwed over from past record companies and stuff like that.
Step close to the mic, bigger.
From past record companies, and he was in a group, so I didn't want to be in no group. So I knew it can flow, so it was just like, I didn't want to be tied down with nobody. Like, can't nobody tell me what to write or nothing like that. So it was just like, I handled it. So Got Bands Entertainment, I started at LLC, then I just start pitching singles, like boom, boom, boom. Boom.
When you go back, right, and I was, remember I wrote about you in Stupid Dope, and I was saying, I was at Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles. Shout out to the whole team over there. They're great. And I said, I was going through your catalog, and I said, man, artwork really tells a lot about a person. And you had your shirt off, you were just wild. I said, what is wanging? What is this? What is that? And I see you now, you know, you sophisticated. You know, you got the suit on. You at the horse dirt with your lady. You doing, talk about big. You know, you sitting in front of the roads. You got the driveway with the green grass. Like, explain to the audience your mindset with the no shirt off and the jeans.
Man, that was crazy.
Break that down.
That was it.
Come here a little bit.
It was crazy. It was a young version. It was just a young version of me.
Explain. Like, I don't mean to cut you off. Just explain, like, where were you in
your mind?
Yeah. Just where were you?
Mindset. For real. Just out there, like streetwise, street mental, like just out there. You know, everybody want to be a trapper.
Right, and then I see that, and then you got I Want It All. With the lady I like, her voice.
Brianna Mar.
Yeah, I always say I like her voice.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all like Tammy Terrell, Marvin Gaye, kind of like, y'all got a match. So, and then you have Just Another Day.
Mm-hmm.
The artwork changed, the tempo changed, the lyrics changed. Because I'm listening to your lyrics, then as a writer, I'm like, okay, you rapping my days, rapping my dad. That really ain't. Like, what's the other song you had? That will go weighing in. What's the other one? Stupid Cooley Swag. Yeah, I'm like, what were you talking about? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, all this stuff. And I'm like saying,
bouncing off the wall.
Yeah, you was like, you know, I'm like, he must have been definitely working independent. He wasn't working with radio pushes. But it's like, to see, so when you think about those moments, right? You know, I always tell people, like, I don't focus on the progress. I focus on the process. I keep mastering my process.
Right.
Whatever I gotta do to get better, that's all I wanna focus on. Like, I don't even get sales figures to it's time to file taxes. Like, I don't even know how much we earning. Mm-hmm. I don't even care. Because if I focus on the money, I won't focus on where I'm going.
Right.
I'm focused on, we got to create Spotify Green. We got to create this. I got to get this. So I never worry about money. I never worry about generating, because I feel like if I'm creating things that people want, people will come and occupy these buildings. That's more important. So in that moment, right, you're going through this metamorphosis change. Like, explain briefly, like, where were you at with your music, and did you feel lost? Did you feel directionless? Because, you know, all that's a part of the game.
I can never feel lost because I got God on my side, and that's one thing my pops installed in me. You can never be lost.
Right.
Like, for real, for real. As long as you keep pushing, and somebody will, he will send somebody your way. And, you know, that's what
you always
is.
Say that. You always say that.
Just send somebody your way. You just got to be doing the right thing. You know what I mean? Right frequencies in the earth. You'll be rewarded.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Talk about this. Your pops, and then we're gonna get into your mom a little bit. Like, you know, you and I, when we speak about, you know, black men,
right,
fathers, it's important. You know, I grew up with my pops, mm-hmm, and moms. I grew up military, so it was like no excuses. It was always get it done, time to perform, a lot of time to prepare. I'm not asking you twice. I'm not gonna look over my shoulder with you. You're gonna create freedom for yourself. See, these are terms that stick in my head.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I live. Like, you get an opportunity to come before money. See, I'm bred it different. And I know you are too. That's why we've had like intense conversation, but it's a lot of respect between us.
Right.
Because we both go hard at what we do. And I appreciate that. Because I don't mind being pushed as long as I'm not going in the wrong direction.
Right.
So, your pops, in the next 90 seconds, how you feel about him?
Wonderful man. Taught me a lot, for real. Spiritually and mentally and for physically. Sure. You know what I mean? And he taught me, you know, him listening to music and different levels and having an ear.
Mm-hmm.
Taught me that, how to stay in tune.
Yeah.
Some things you can't get from a man. Like, for real, it's got to be your dad.
Right. Yeah.
So.
Because he love you. He know you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? He part of your life cycle. When you got married, the night before, what did he tell you? You remember? What did he tell you about your lady? What did he tell you, you know, about your life and the way he felt about you that moment?
Shoot, do you remember? I don't.
I'm just asking.
Because I don't think.
No, I'm saying like.
Me and her, like, when we got married, like, after it, like, I think we just got, did we get missing or something? Then we just stayed away from everybody.
No, what I'm saying is that, what did he tell, let me rephrase it. What did he tell you, let's just say afterwards, you know, like you know, like when y'all had a chance to get down to.
He married us.
Okay, that's what I'm saying, yeah.
He married us.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
He married us, so it was just like, he was our priest, like.
That's what I'm saying, yeah.
Yeah, he married us, man. He said, you did good, son.
Good.
Yeah.
Good, that's a good thing, that's good. No, I'm just saying, because that's important. You know, your father's influence is everything.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it's good or bad.
Right.
It can be horrible, and you're going to remember that for the rest of your life. Or it can be good, and you can remember for the rest of your life. You know, like me, certain things still, I wake up off of that time clock in my head of what he said. You know, as soon as you open your eyes, get moving. When you open your eyes, you need to move. Don't lay down. When you see open, get moved. That's how I think. So it's like, I'm all sharp mentality. Let me go into this part here. You know, mother's the first teacher of the child, right? Baby come out, mom's holding it. That's what the child remembers. You, your mom, church, music, big head bands. What was your mom like for you?
Oh, she was tough. She was a tough cookie. For real. You had to do your homework at the table. You had to finish it. You got bad grades. She on your butt. She worldwide wrecking crew. Like, but you got to love her because she your mama, you know?
No doubt about it.
I mean, she teach you not to fall for stupid stuff.
Right.
You know what I mean? Don't be a dummy.
Right, don't be a dummy, right?
You know what I mean?
Measure twice, cut once.
Right.
Type stuff, you know what I'm saying?
Don't be a fool.
Mm-hmm.
Especially for success.
Right. As you grew in your life, maturity-wise, with your home life and your child and your situation, how much did the influence of how they raised you play into your growth?
A lot.
Yeah.
She crack on me right now because I make dad jokes with the kids. Like, She be like, that's a dad joke. Like, yeah, like, it'd be weird. Like, I'd be like, dang, man, I'm really that dude. Like,
it's like the insurance commercial. I'm gonna be like my parents.
Right. Like, but it's a blessing, man. Yeah, no doubt. It's a blessing, man, for real.
TikTok. Okay, so your son, who you love, and you was talking about, my dad's TikTok star. So you got all these followers on TikTok. You jumping on trampolines, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, your son on TikTok, he see you with these followers. Like, how do you got the blue check now, you verified? How does he look at you now? Like,
He talk mess. He go to school and talk mess. Like, for real. Like, your daddy ain't verified. he talk mess. I mean, he talk that mess. Like, but you can't, I mean, long as it don't get too irate and out of control, do your due, son.
How does he feel about you being like a, you know, rapper slash dad slash superhero? How you feel about all that?
I'm still an old man to him. Like, old man, bald head. I mean, it's family. We don't need, he don't.
Yeah.
It's dad.
Of course. Yeah, yeah. I seen y'all at the, y'all was at the Smoothie Center, the basketball game. That was cool. Before we jump into music real quick, I want to talk about this. How did you transform the pain in your life into the music? How did you integrate it all? Because I hear it, you know, in the music. I hear it.
Man, it's just something like you reach in. It's just a spirit, like you reach in your heart. You know what I mean? It's just like the stuff you can't say, but you can say it.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean? It's just something I took in when I was a young kid.
Yeah, yeah. Like,
just writing poems. Just simple. Yep. Simplify it. And then start rhyming. Then you start leveling it out.
Yeah, leveling it out. All right. Musically, you've done a lot. Independent. Self-financed, self-made, boss. You never took a handout. You never took a shortcut. You never took the escalator, as I tell people in the masterclass. You really grinded at this, man. Put your money up. You put your faith in people you were working with, radio pushers. You put your faith in yourself first. You've accomplished a lot in a 2-year window, independent. I mean, a lot. From press, media, music, your sound, your visuals, everything you do now, people respond to it. A lot of, I tell you all the time, you know, I say you got a blue check now, so make sure you respond to everybody, because people look up to you. Because, like, you know, a lot of people, even though we didn't know where we were going, I just told you, wherever I write for, you going to go.
Right.
That's what I told you. I said, you just keep investing. I'm going to do my part because that's my job. You know, I'm Brady. You Randy Moss. Just keep getting open. I'm going to throw you the ball. That's how I was for a long time. Mm-hmm. So, musically, what place are you in right now when you put together a song? Like, what is your, like, level of confidence? What's your level of bravado? Like, when you walk, like, you about to walk in the booth right here. We had the House of Hits, man. You know, 129 million records sold have gone through this building. Daddy Yankee, Migos, Jack Harlow, Kanye West been right here. You about to walk in this booth and rip it down and turn into a monster, a whole different person, like Beyonce and Sasha Fierce, Sean Corey Carter, Jay-Z, you know, Christopher Wallace, Biggie Smalls. Where are you with your music right now?
Zoom in on me.
This guy.
Zoom in.
I'm the best in the nation.
I'm not playing. It's game time. Big head. Got bands.
All right. So, in a wrap-up session, first of all, thank you for answering the questions, honestly. You know, you put a lot of passion in. This is what I wanted. I want an organic, no script, nothing written down.
Try to jerk some tears out of me too,
hey,
bro.
Man.
You ain't right for that.
I wouldn't be the GOAT if I didn't. I wouldn't be the GOAT. A lot of people are gonna be watching this.
Yeah, you're right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So when they come
it's
in,
all real.
Yeah, it's gonna make them feel like, you know, I gotta, cause everybody can't get to me.
No.
You know that, right?
Right.
So I'm real selective about, and you have to be selective with art. You have to be selective with your gift, because I was born with this. So I don't need a script. God gave me a script. I just follow it. So I believe if whatever you are here to do, because everybody was born to do something, you just got to find it.
I have a friend. She's one of the most nicest people in the world. Right? She died of cancer. But her gift was the ability to unify people. That was her gift. She could unify anybody. She could unify Russia and Ukraine right now if she wanted to. That's just how. But that was her gift. You know what I'm saying? That's what we called her. She was a mama to everybody. If you knew her, that was Mama B. Mm-hmm. So she had that gift. So everybody has something that they have within them that they just need to bring out. That's part of God's plan for you. So my thing is this, right? As you look at everything that you've been through, everything you've accomplished, everything you've sacrificed, everything your team has sacrificed as far as everything to get you here, because you know this has been a journey to get to right here.
Oh yeah.
At this moment, you know, we've been talking about it for a minute and going through different metamorphoses and different changes, different things. But they always say when you arrive at your destination, every bump, every turbulence, everything you went through, it was supposed to be. So right now, with the music you're making right now in 2022, what type of image, what type of message you want to send to people in 2022 about the God Bands Entertainment label and Big Ed Bands as an artist?
Powerful, soulful, heartfelt, you know, good music. You know what I mean? It make you want to move. It's just like I'm just trying to make it do what it do.
No doubt about it. How do you feel about being in this building today? How does it make you feel?
Man, I feel like...
Step in a little bit.
I feel very special.
Okay.
Because I have my family here.
No doubt.
Friends. I mean, shoot. What more can I say? I'm blessed.
How you feel about the interview today, man? We finally got a chance to...
Yeah, man, you ain't right for that crying stuff, man. I don't do that, bro. But yeah, man, yeah, it was wonderful.
Felt like we did it justice?
Yeah, we did it justice.
Did it justice?
Yes, sir.
I wanted to bring a 60 Minutes, Don Lemon, Sway in the Universe type vibe to it.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're more than just a rapper, man.
Right.
You realize I only use that word 3 times in the interview.
Mm-hmm.
Because I wanted people to purposely see you as a person, because we're all people. We just here to do different things to help the world be a better place. So right. Again, like I never say, call me CEO, call me a boss, call me Jay.
Yeah.
That's what you say. Jay, what's up? I don't go off titles. I don't even have radio pushes nowhere around me, because I am that. You know what I'm saying? So to me, it's like my actions speak louder than anything I can say. So you is the same way. So, you know, it's an honor seeing your growth, seeing that rose go through concrete. Maybe think of the book with Tupac.
Mm-hmm.
I bought a book of poetry, his book of his poetry. Think about that butterfly comes from that cocoon. To see you get to this point and not, like, people don't realize you were on Sway. You were interviewed by Sway, the real Sway, years ago. People don't know, like, the history you have. People don't know about the different struggles you have. Family-wise, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, jealousy, beefs, different things. But you've kept one thing at the focal point, and I want to end it on this, family. And I think that's, regardless if you get a platinum plaque or not, to me, you already went diamond.
Right.
In life. You know what I'm saying? So that, to me, that's an accomplishment more than losing your soul to something that you never gained anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to thank you for being on the Hip Hop's of 1987 House of His Studio podcast today. Now we about to break into this studio session.
All right.
We're going to rip it down for this vlog. We're doing this exclusive vlog, Big Ed Bands, House of His, produced by my man Ozzy in the building. The great Ozzy in the building. So we got to get him in the booth, man. So that's a wrap for us. House of His, Hip Hop's of 1987. Big Ed Bands, people.
Big Ed got bands.
House of Hits Studio in Miami. The premier audio and visual studio experience in the world. Undisputed, undeniable, can't be refuted on any level. When you walk through these doors, you are walking into greatness, supreme being. DJ Khaled, Mary J. Blige, Busta Rhymes, Jack Harlow, the Migos, Kanye West, The Game, when they want to document their greatness and record their legacy. In Miami, when they touch down House of His Studios. Period. There's certain places you go. There's certain environments you want to be inside to reach your optimum level, your zenith. When people go and play the Madison Square Garden in New York City, they play at a higher level than they do in any other stadium. That's because they know the history of that building. Same thing here with the House of His Studio in Miami. The ecosystem they've created is on another level. Hip-hop since 1987, the number one hip-hop blog and media outlet in the world, undisputed, cannot be denied, cannot be refuted. Since 1987, they have been the most connected brand to the streets, documenting the authentic stories without compromising integrity. They don't do it for clout at Hip Hop since 1987. They do it for the purity of the game, giving you the real story. The first Meek Mill freestyle ever recorded on Hip Hop since 1987. Sitting down with Nipsey Hussle back in 2014 talking about Victory Lap before it was even released. Shout out to the great Nipsey Hussle. Hip Hop since 1987, House of His Studios in Miami. Two juggernauts, two conglomerates. Now we document history. Now we record our legacy. Welcome to the Hip Hop Since 1987 podcast, coming to you live from the House of His Studio in Miami. Let's get it, people. You know how we do it.